Hi everyone, how are you my dear children? Hope you all are safe and fine. As you can see, today we are going to discuss the last part of this first chapter, unit and measurement, accuracy and precision. Before going to this, let us discuss one example based on the propagation of error. In last class, we have finished the propagation of error. What we have finished? Last formula, if x is equal to a to the power p and b to the power q and c to the power r, then what is delta x by x? This is your maximum fractional error we are talking about in x, will be p times of delta a by a, then q times of delta b by b, then r times of delta c by c. This we have discussed. And how to calculate the percentage error? Simply we will multiply 100. Here also 100, here also 100, here also we will multiply 100 and here also we will multiply 100. This formula we have discussed. Now let us discuss one example to visualize this formula. Calculate the percentage of error. Calculate the percentage of error in determination of g is equal to 4 pi square l by t square, 4 pi square l by t square, where it is given l is measured with plus minus 2% of error, okay, and your t is measured with plus minus 3% of error. You have to calculate the percentage of error in this determination. Okay, how to do it? Let us start. So g is equal to 4 pi square l by t square. So what is delta g by g? Delta g by g is equal to plus minus of delta l by l plus t square. So power will multiply delta t by t. Okay, here also we'll percentage, na? So we'll multiply 100. Let me write it again. Let me write over here. Delta g by g, percentage of error we are calculating, okay? Plus minus delta l by l into 100, then plus delta t by t. Here we will multiply 2. 2 times of delta t by t. Okay, into 100. Is it clear? Then everything is given. So 2, it is given. Then plus 2 into, here it is given 3. Okay, this much of percent. So what is the percentage error? 2 plus 6. That means plus minus 8%. Is it clear? This is small example. Next two lectures we will be discussing all such previous year NEET and JEE mains question. Okay? Okay. Noted it down. Now let us discuss accuracy and precision. Most confused portion for the kids or children. You can say, don't tell us kids. So, this is the most confused part. What is accuracy? What does it mean? Accuracy means it is a measure of how close the measured value is to your true value of the quantity. Okay? Suppose to measure the length of a book, I have assigned Geeta, Rohan, okay, and Rahul. I have assigned it measure the length of a book. So Geeta has given the measurement 20.6 centimeter. Okay. Rohan has given the measurement 21.302 centimeter suppose. Rahul has given the measurement like 20.72 centimeter suppose. Okay. Then which one is accurate? But what is the actual length? Actual length is given, that is actual length of the book is given is 20.5 centimeter. Okay, then which measurement is more closer to your actual length? This one. See, that means Gita's measure value is more accurate as it is more closer to your actual length. Understood? What is accuracy? Okay, how close to the actual value? That is accuracy. Now, precision. What is this precision? Precision means it is a very big, difficult statement in all the books. It tells us up to what resolution or limit the quantity is measured. And it depends on the least count of the instrument. What is this least count? Let us first understand. Then automatically we will understand the precision. Precision means how precise our measurement is. So least count. Least count means it is the minimum value that we can measure. Okay. Least count means it is the minimum value that we can measure. So least count of vernier calipers. When you do the experiments, you will use this least count of vernier caliper is 0.01 centimeter and least count of screw gauge is 0.001 centimeter. Now tell me which one is more precise. Screw gauge is more precise than your vernier caliper. So precision means how precise or how specific you are with your measurement. Let us try to understand with an example. Suppose I will say like my shoe length is 0.001 centimeter smaller than your shoe length. Okay, my shoe length is 0.001 centimeter smaller than your shoe length. Now our another friend Rima, what she told? She told her shoe is 0.4 Rima. This is for me. Okay, for Rima 0.1 centimeter smaller than your shoe length. Okay, this is for Rima. Okay, tell me now who is more precise with the information. I am telling ki my shoe is 0.001 centimeter than less than your smaller than your shoe, and Rima another friend is telling 0.1 centimeter smaller than your shoe. Okay, that means I am giving more precise information. Is it clear? I am giving more precise information. Now let us try to understand again this, because this is very confusing. Least count of scale. Let me erase this much. See, least count of scale. What is the least count of scale? Anybody? Can you people tell me? It is 0.1 centimeter, children. That means which scale you can measure the length like 12.1 centimeter or 12.3 centimeter like this. But you can't measure the length like this 12.001 centimeter. Can you measure with the scale this length? Can you measure this? No, it is not possible because this is the least count. Okay, are you getting? So that means precision. So it is, when I am telling it is more precise, so more precise means least counts has to be small. Let us try to understand. Suppose I reached at your place at 2 o'clock 10 minutes and suppose 3 seconds. Again I am telling I reached at your place at 2 o'clock 10 minutes. Tell me which one is more precise. Definitely this one is more precise. This is more precise information. Like least count of scale is 0.1 centimeter. But least count of screw gauge? Least count of screw gauge is 0.001 centimeter. So which one is more precise? Obviously screw gauge will give more precise measured value. That means precision. This is less than your this least count. That means just remember children, a important conclusion based on this, precision is inversely proportional to your least count. That means if least count decreases, your precision is more. How? Here least count of the screw gauge is less than your least count of scale. It is more precise. This screw gauge measurement will give you more precise information. Is it clear, children? One more thing. Is more precise value is more accurate? No, not necessary. Both are independent. Accuracy and precision, both are independent, children. See in this example. Rohan has gave more precise measured value. But Gita has given more accurate. So this is more precise and this is more accurate. Got it? What is accuracy and precision? Hope it is clear to you. Okay? If any doubt, please leave a comment in comment section box so that I can address your doubts and I will try my best to clarify it. So in my next lecture, we will be discussing previous year NEET and JEE Mains question. Okay children, take care children and thank you for watching.